In the Elohim, God. I come to extract from you what you will give me of the warring in your members. We place our electronic presence over the mother. For the mother has often desired and has taken you individually into her arms to take from you the burdens and the sorrows and the pain and the confusion and the misunderstanding. Now we place our electronic presence over her that we might absorb it, that we might take from you that which the great law will allow and that which you will release. Decide if you will release your illnesses, your infirmities, your schisms, your bad habits, your momentums not of the light. Decide now whether you will keep them as crutches, as maneuvers of manipulation. Decide whether you can let go and be God where you are. The process may follow, beloved, but this initial encounter with Elohim, peace and aloha, will give you the thrust you have been waiting for to be divested of records and hurts. Therefore, sound the Om as you release to us your burdens. Oh. Come unto us, all ye who labor and are heavy laden. We give you rest. We take your turmoil and terror and temerity. We come to give you resolution in the name of the Prince of Peace. Continue to release, 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 release as we speak. Thus, beloved, the message is clear. Peace is not everywhere in the earth, and war is where it should not be, and war is where it should be stopped and is not stopped. Of what avail, what use or purpose the governments of the nations, if it is not to preserve life and preserve the peace? Things have gone far out of line. Elohim can scarcely contact individuals upon earth, for they are so far out of line that they should suffer loss of identity should we approach. As Gautama has said, so it is true of us. We reach them through you when you are in alignment. Many do not understand their out of alignment state. What a pity. Therefore, seek God and know him as peace. The best you can do is be at peace, be peaceful where you are, and to call to us, to give our mantra, to give the call for the great sun disk, to guard the solar plexus, and to send forth rays of golden, pink, and purple fire. Withdraw the warring in your own members, give it to us, and know the crown jewel of peace. When you have enlightenment, you are peace. When you have it not, you do not see your non-peaceful state. I represent Elohim in the heart this day. All are present, some whose names you have not. We are manifesting in the earth, in all areas, and concentrating here, a light that is intended to assist all evolutions to come to peace, to challenge war and its advocates, and to defend the peace by whatever means necessary to prevent war. War is the agenda of the fallen ones on this and other systems, and their agenda is for war on planet Earth. Disarmament and the seeming disappearance of world communism does not change that fact in any way. The Buddhas are the warriors of peace. The cosmic Christs are the warriors of peace. Therefore, the defense of life at all levels must be secured. When life in the womb is not defended, so the nations also disarm, and they are not defended. It is karmic. It is blindness. It is so because of the depths to which many have descended in consciousness, in their little value which they place on human life. Human life is of ultimate value, for it is the lowest level to which anyone can descend and still have a soul and still become one with God. When you go below the human species, that option is not there. Therefore, know, beloved, that many upon earth in human bodies have descended as far as they can go and still have opportunity. Opportunity will not come to the unpeaceful ones. Thus, may you be champions, warriors of peace, and understand that pacifism is a perversion of peace. Peace is the guardian action of the sixth ray. Peace takes care of life. Peace enters in and binds those who deny life, who deny the disciple, who deny the guru, who deny their oneness with God. Peace enters in where those pretending to be Chelas and are not Chelas shall find themselves in outer darkness. It is high time that you consider what it means to make a commitment to an ascended master guru. You do not break those commitments, beloved ones, for anyone. Therefore, see to it that you are in the right line and the straight line with your God and your service. Opportunities do not come again to those who have had so many in so many lifetimes. Therefore, beloved, it is not words, but light, empowerment, and profound love that we bring. We seal this session in the power of the resurrection flame, that you might drink it in as the rays of light of Helios and Vesta. We are Elohim all, from the great central sun through the vast cosmos. We salute the entire spirit of the Great White Brotherhood and the true Chelas of the Living Word, who keep their word no matter what the price. I salute you on this day. May your joy in the cosmic flame of freedom be full, and may you know whence came to you this gift of joy. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and the Divine Mother, I seal you in the light of God that never fails.